is making my skull itch.
Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Planescape Torment Blind. Go visit some more people, see if they have anything new to say.
Portal detected.
Where is it? Yeah.
Portal detected.
Definitely asked that, but have you heard of a night hag named Ravel? The night hag sought to sunder this city. Her greatest works were those of unmaking. She walked the path of entropy. Do you know of a citadel called the Fortress of Regrets? It is a place of shadows, a fortress not even this tower can breach. Well, guys, I forgot to start my timer here. You know anything more about it?
Updated my journal.
It is a memorial that has forgotten itself. It now decays in darkness, slowly dying among the skies of the negative material plane. Do you know how to reach it? No. I know I can buy these special bolts for him, but I'm not even going to bother. Let's go the upper. They don't sound like they're engaging in intellectual things. Kesai-Serris smiles warmly as you draw near her, pushing a wavy lock of hair away from her bright crimson eyes. Well, greetings once again. Something I can do for you, Hello, Kesai. I bring you news of your mother. Kesai sighs. Must you remind me always? I am no happier about my lineage now than I was when you first told me of it. She is dead, Kesai. Kesai stops abruptly, then laughs. You must be joking. Ravel dead? How? What could possibly kill her? I was forced to kill her in self-defense. I took no pleasure in it. I see. Several conflicting expressions cross her exotic visage, difficult to interpret. And why do you feel a need to tell me this? Because there's more. She spoke of you near the end. Kesai recoils, looking terrified. She did? May the powers help me. What did she say? Let me explain, please. It wasn't Ravel exactly that spoke of you. Ravel has still been living in Sigil all this time, in a way, or various aspects of her dead. One aspect was an old herbalist midwife who made her home in Ragbreaker Square. Her name was Mebeth. Mebeth? I've heard of her, but I've never met her. She's one of the few people in the hive that some in the upper wards would occasionally seek out for her charms and herbs. Yes, that sounds like the woman I speak of. After my confrontation with Ravel in the Lady's Maze, I visited Mebeth, and there discovered that Mebeth was dying. As an aspect of Ravel, she could not long survive the true Ravel's death. Kasai is listening intently, fascinated by your story. Go on. Before Mebeth died, she spoke with regret that she could not show you kindness, for as she put it, there is a saying on the plains that a hag's kindness is crueler than her hate, and poisons all it touches. Are you saying that this Mebeth, that she wasn't evil, like my mother? You just said she was a part of her. An aspect, yes. Even Ravel had a kind side, I think, and I believe Mebeth was the purest expression of that part of her. She showed me kindness, and asked for little in return. I'm grateful to her. Kasai looks at you, even more conflicted now. And you think this part of her wished to be a mother to me, to show me kindness, but feared her nature would bring me harm? That is what I gathered from her last words, yes. She shudders involuntarily, then sighs. I'm not sure if I should be grateful that you've told me this, but now that I know, I have to know the full truth of it. Give me a moment to ask my father of this. Take your time. I'll wait here if you don't mind. I would know what he says also. Kasai stares at you silently for a time, then nods. Give me a moment. She turns from you and begins to mutter softly as she did once before. The air begins to shimmer around her slightly and fills with a coppery smell like warm blood. Strain her ears to understand what she's saying or overhear. You lean towards Kasai, attempting to hear what she's saying. Hogazanenel, banished prince of Ithag, Marquis of the Bloody Shadow, my father.
Sorry.
And she yawns. Hear me, for I must call upon you once again. Her voice is low and hushed as she continues, and the only thing you can hear in her voice is a deep sadness. Kasai returns to you, her exotic eyes rimmed with tears. My father confirms your tale. My mother is indeed no longer among the living. As I said, I am sorry, Kasai. I will leave you to your thoughts. Farewell. Wait a moment, please. There is more. My father said that you showed my mother a kindness at the end, one he would like to repay. A kindness? You mean the barb seed from the garden I gave her? Precisely. My father asked me to tell you that something you seek lies in your dreams. I found a means to dream again, but I didn't find anything I sought in them.
Updated my journal.
Perhaps you should try again. Perhaps. Okay, so back to the dream shaper. She sighs, pondering you, then seems to come to a reluctant decision. Perhaps I can be of help in this matter. You know that I've always been fascinated with dreams. Learning of my heritage has made me realize why. The blood of the Grey Wastes in me means I have power over dreams, though I've never used it because I never knew I possessed it. But perhaps I could use it on your behalf in this instance. Hags are known to ride men's dreams and turn them to nightmare and ride them to their death.
Updated my journal.
I doubt I could do something like that, nor would I want to, but it is possible I could accompany you in your dreams and could perhaps help you find whatever it is my father has spoken of. Would you be willing? I realize it would be a great invasion of privacy, but perhaps I could render aid that would make it worthwhile to you. Number four is nasty. Well, that's a flirty one, number one. Let's be serious, though. I would appreciate any aid you can render, Kasai. Thank you kindly. All right, give me some time to prepare myself. Come back in a day, and we'll go to this dream machine you spoke of. Come back in a day. It's a day. Are you ready, Kasai? I think it's time we explored my dreams. Not yet. I need a little more time. Remember, I've never tried this before, and only recently found out that I'd even be capable of it. It shouldn't take me long. Shouldn't take long for me to try what I have in mind as I practice, though. Come back later. Huh. Abel Ponder thought. The man's eyes pass over you, gleaming as they fix on Nordom. A quadrone, is he? He looks puzzled. However, oh my, a rogue Modron. Oh dear, he looks quite distressed. What's wrong? Well, he's a rogue. He is a contaminated Modron, and such a Modrons only drain power from their home plane, Mechanus. You see, all Modrons hold some of the source of Mechanus with them. When one is not working properly or leaves the other Modrons, it weakens all of Mechanus. Go on. When the other Modrons, find him, they will take him back to Mechanus to be punished. He will be destroyed. The broken Modron must return to the source. But why? Because he is not a Modron, yet he drains them with his presence. He weakens Mechanus without cause or right. He must become part of Mechanus to be corrected. I don't want him corrected. Nordom likes being what he is. He is terribly misguided, then. There are people I can contact. Don't. I had some questions. Nah, that's it. Kesai looks a bit disheveled, but strangely more confident than the last time you saw her. Hello again, and before you ask, yes, I'm sure I can help you now. Nini volunteered to allow me to visit her dreams last night. I figured if anyone's dreams should be relatively safe to visit, it would be hers. She pauses, then whispered, I had no idea. I don't think she has any idea. Mort bobs up and down. Oh, you can't leave it at that. Come on, I have to know. Kesai shakes her head. No, I promised to respect her privacy. I won't share what was there. I shouldn't have even said that much. I'm afraid I'm just... still... recovering. She closes her eyes for a moment and gulps at the memory. That's too bad. I'm as intrigued as Mort, but very well, I won't pry. Mort starts banging his forehead against the nearby wall. The planes are so cruel. Bang, bang. Thank you for understanding, and you have my word that I'll keep whatever we find in your dreams in the same confidence. Shall we go? Let's. And Kesai, thank you again for this. I shouldn't come in with you, but I should be able to reach your dreams from out here. You may or may not perceive me in your dreams. Nanny didn't. She shudders again. Go on in. I'll be there watching and keeping an eye out for anything that could be of help to you. Oh, and there's something else. I do not have the power to let you bring anything you find in your dreams out with you, but I should be able to let you bring things in. Should it be necessary, anything you're carrying with you when you enter the machine should be available to you in your dreams. Beware, however, anything you consume or drop in your dreams will likely be gone forever. Good luck. Alright, let's save, because if this is a cutscene, it might be, we might crash. Once again, you find yourself under a hangman's noose. You find yourself clutching a barbed seed tightly in your left hand. The gravelly voice cackles. Another dream. Another. Another. Wait. Who? Intruders. As before, your body seems strangely light and airy, like you've lost control of it. This time, however, the winds that blow about you seem directed somehow. You know you are not alone, though you cannot perceive another soul. Oh. You find yourself in the mortuary, surrounded by those you've coerced via various means to follow you. They are speaking to you, but their words pass over and past you like the sound of many shuffling feet. As they prattle on with their inane questions, you check off in your mind all the preparations you've made for this journey. So DNR is definitely there. I've got a skeleton there. I don't know if he's actually with us. And there's Mort. And what's his name? I can't remember his name. Hold on a second. Itch. Dakan, of course. Oh, you find yourself in your room in the fest hall, and you approach the storage closet you had commissioned, the one that can only be opened if you know what's inside. You move to put three objects inside, the final pieces of your legacy, to your future coronation, should your trip to the negative material plane not go as planned. Making a trip to the negative material plane. Oh, this Kesai-Serris, I do see her. This is the one I couldn't open. I couldn't open that, right? From the edge of your vision, a strikingly exotic-looking woman approaches with fangs and blue skin. You could swear you know her, yet you're also sure you've never seen her before. How these things can both be true doesn't seem to bother you much for some reason. Who are you? Oh, just another aspiring sensate floating about the fest hall. I saw you through your open door and couldn't resist finding out more about you. May I ask you what you're doing? I'm preparing for a very dangerous journey. Always have to think several steps ahead. I have a habit of forgetting things, so I'm just leaving myself some mementos. I see. How fascinating. Such as? She looks to see what you hold in your hands, but when you look down, all you are holding are three barbed seeds. Ah, well, there's a key. I had these doors designed so that you must use the key from the inside. You must be able to clearly visualize something inside in order to open them. Clever, eh? And a message to myself. But no, you may not read it. And lastly, a stout little weapon I picked up in Undersigil the other day. I can't make any use of it, but maybe someday I'll be able to, so I might as well leave it behind for the next me. You must clearly visualize something inside in order to open them. Ooh, Undersigil? I've never been there. She approaches you seductively, placing her hand on your chest, and you can't help but appreciate her astoundingly voluptuous form. I've heard it's so dangerous. Can you show me what it's like? Sure, why not? Dianara won't be back for a bit. She's visiting with that fool of a father of hers. As long as you promise not to tell her. She's a jealous thing, and I still have need of her. Okay, this is the jerkwad version of himself. You can't be sure if the woman just grimaced, but the look is gone almost instantly. Oh, of course, I won't say a word. I just love to see it, though. You place the barbed seeds in the closet and close the doors. Let's go, then. Okay, so we gotta go back there. Suddenly, you're back in Undersigil, and from the southeast passage, the roars of ferocious demons reverberate down the halls. Hear that? I killed those a few nights ago. All by myself, too, you lie. I found a nice prize in the room, too. The blue-skinned woman gasps prettily. Really? Can I see? Can you show me how you kill those ferocious beasts? That's so fascinating. You know this woman is manipulating you, for it's something you've done often enough yourself, but for some reason you are unable to resist. That'll be easy enough. Stay right here. I'll be right back. I don't want to fight them. Just let it automate itself. As you approach the creatures, suddenly you're no longer there at the woman's behest. You're approaching these creatures for the first time, exploring Undersigil, looking for something useful for your upcoming journey. You're such a fascinating man. Please show me again how you defeated these enormous monsters. It'd be such an exciting experience. The girls at the fest hall would be so jealous, and I'd be ever so grateful. I want to fight them by myself. I don't want to fight them at all, actually. I've had enough of that. Thank you. greater glabrezu. You find yourself back in the foundry. Kasai's breasts are heaving as she tries to catch her breath. After a moment, she whispers, "That was an intense experience, I must say. I think I can bring you back to that dream if you wish to prepare and return to try again. You will need to defeat all of those creatures in your dreams to find what you seek. I will await you here. I'd like to investigate this machine with your permission. I think I could learn much about dreams from it. It is truly an incredible achievement." "Certainly, Kasai. Thank you for your help. I will prepare myself and return to try again."
Updated my journal.
How can I defeat them by myself? How the hell are we gonna defeat him?
Don't let it end like this.
All right now, aren't we?
Kasai rushes to you. Oh no, again? You poor thing, that must hurt terribly, even if it is only in dreams. I'm all right, Kasai, but thank you. Looks like I'll need to prepare some more. I guess I just weaken it little by little. I didn't cast it. I lost a spell too. He's not moving anymore. That doesn't do much, does it?
I'm gone.
that a glitch in the game, or really it's not supposed to pass us? Doing anything. Still got another one, right? Starting to run out of spells. I didn't do anything. Missing. So one of them hit. I'm out of spells. Waste. I don't think friends will work. That's something I could use. Identifier. Okay. Mm-hmm. 8 damage, is that? Not doing enough damage this time. That didn't do anything.
Looks like beauty sleep hasn't helped you any.
How am I supposed to beat this exactly? Alright guys, I gotta think about this. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.